Sounds as if I mic'd up properly. Okay, so yeah, second part of the double header. I'm Simon Hodgson, and I'm responsible for the Managing Research Data Program. So I'll talk for a few slides about that program in particular. Okay, right, now it's not skipping on there, okay? Here we go. Juan warned you that there would be another representation of a life cycle. I use this slide to try and introduce the way in which we've analyzed our intervention and the way we target within the Managing Research Data Program how the sort of output and the sort of activities we want the projects to do in order to support researchers within UK institutions in the process of managing the research data. So in order to do that, it's useful to break down the research data life cycle. The particular one that you can see in front of you is based loosely upon the Australian National Data Service's data sharing verbs. It doesn't pretend to be comprehensive, but it's a useful tool. And in particular, the additional pieces out, so the need when upon creation of research data for the data to be stored and annotated at an early stage, after the use stage, for the data to be appraised, potentially discarded or selected for sharing and long-term preservation, and the emphasis upon the handover stage. This is research going on in universities, in other research institutions, and there may be a handover to a national or indeed international data center for the long-term sharing and curation of that data. And of course, towards the end of the life cycle, the publication of the data, perhaps in association with a scholarly publication, and the need for the data to be assigned to an identifier, adequate description for discovery and for effective reuse, and for access to be taken into consideration. Having made that analysis, we divided the objectives of the program into five areas. Some of these areas map across the whole life cycle, some target particular elements of it, but it's useful to do that analysis so that we understand precisely how we're supporting researchers in their activities. So within the program, there are activities designed to develop leadership, essentially, in policy development in UK universities, activities designed to create model guidance and training materials for researchers. We provide support for data management planning targeted at particular disciplinary areas, and that very much in response to the requirements of research funders, which Juan has already alluded to. Some of the projects rather developed research data management systems and infrastructure for storing the research data. And we also had a strand of activity which was designed to indicate the benefits, demonstrate the benefits and that could be obtained by linking research data to scholarly publications thereby getting greater recognition and reward for researchers for publishing their research data, making it publicly available. So the first Managing Research Data Program started in October 2009. It was a total investment of about £4.3 million split over four areas, mapping onto those target areas that I've mentioned. So there's eight large projects developing policy in universities, and above all, providing support structures, human support structures often, and technical infrastructure to help managing research data. There were six projects looking at issues relating to training and skills. As I've mentioned, a number of projects looking at disciplinary requirements for data management planning. And a set of projects looking at linking research data to publications and issues relating to the citation of research data, the challenges involved therein. The outputs from that program are largely available on the web. Some of the projects are still finishing, but most of the outputs are available. And on that outputs page, you can find requirements analyses, links to training materials, guidance documentation, and links to the project software outputs as well. By way of example, I'll talk about two of the projects in the first program. The large infrastructure projects, the eight projects that I mentioned, were roughly split between projects which focused upon taking a disciplinary approach, supporting researchers in a given discipline across a set of institutions, and projects which took the sort of converse approach, if you like, taking an institutional approach, targeting a particular department or faculty in an institution, building a research data infrastructure in the broadest sense of the term to support those researchers. So as an example of the former, I mentioned the FishNet project, which developed an infrastructure for sharing research data. This was based at the Freshwater Biological Association, and it's essentially a platform which researchers can use to deposit their research data and share it with their peers in that particular research area. And it allows embargo periods, it allows the researcher to set various access controls and to assign what degree of sharing they care to undertake. As an example of the institutional approach, I'll mention the MADAM project at the University of Manchester, which worked in the first instance to develop a pilot data management system and infrastructure for biomedical researchers, largely working with image data. They also looked at supporting the research data planning process and integrating their activities with the research office so that the process could be integrated as much as possible with the grant submission system and with the management of the research project through its life cycle. I'll mention then, I'll talk about the new Managing Research Data Program, which started at the beginning of last month as an extension, or as rather a continuation of the MADAM project, or rather a new project at the University of Manchester. Following on from the MADAM project, we funded the MIST project, which takes the MADAM pilot and extends it, has the intention of extending it throughout the institution. There's a quotation there from the project manager of the MIST project, which I think is important because it indicates the way we like to work within the program. I see MIST as a transitional project rather than continuation of MADAM. We're tasked with moving from pilot, that's a pilot in a particular department, to a service across the university. And I firmly believe it's our responsibility to do this in full view of the wider community. So if you're interested in tracking that project or any other projects in the new program, there are web links through which you can do that. So the second Managing Research Data Program, as I said, started at the beginning of last month. There's a total investment, slightly increased investment, £4.6 million. We funded a total of 17 projects in universities tasked with producing, developing institutional research data management policies, support systems and infrastructure. A set of 10 projects continuing the work to provide guidance for particular disciplinary areas to meet funder requirements in terms of research data management planning, and 2 projects looking at enhancing the DCC's data management planning tool online. There isn't, as yet, any more detailed information of those projects on the GISC website, but there is a Google map with some limited information. I'll mention some of the subject divisions was quite interesting. Largely in response to the new EPSRC data management policy, we have a nice cluster of projects looking at the challenges of managing engineering research data, and there's also predictably perhaps a set of projects looking at biomedical and health sciences. We've got a launch meeting at the beginning of December, and the projects will be some of the projects at least will be presenting posters at the IDCC, the International Digital Curation Conference, which Neil has already mentioned. I need to mention briefly a parallel activity which GISC is undertaking thanks to resource from the University Modernization Fund. This is the Shared Services and Cloud Program, which is exploring ways of achieving efficiencies through conducting research data management and storage in trusted clouds. As part of that project, a brokerage has been set up to provide trusted clouds for the higher education sector, and there's a pilot cloud being developed by EduServe. The role of the Digital Curation Center has been expanded as a result of that funding as well, and four research data management applications, largely building on work from the first managing research data program are being developed for managing research data in a cloud context. I mentioned those four applications very quickly. The VIDAS project and the Dataflow project stem directly from previous projects. They're non-discipline specific. They're data management platforms. The one, a database as a service, and the second, a two-tier data management platform, which can be used in principle for any disciplinary area, and they'll be fitted to use in a virtualized environment. The second two projects, the smart research framework, is targeted at chemistry and crystallography, and essentially revolves around using electronic lab notebooks and a blogging system for research data management. The final project, the Brisket project, targets the use of research data from medical and hospital environments, and obviously there's issues related to data security involved. Finally, I'll mention the role of the Digital Curation Center in support and in parallel to the program. The Digital Curation Center's strapline, because good research data, because good research needs good data, I think is very important and something that we can all hold by. Partly as a result of the University Modernization Fund, as I said, the activities of the DCC have been expanded and extended, and they're running a set of regional data management roadshows, of which information is on the DCC website. They've also been producing a set of briefing papers and how-to guides and further developing data management tools. Now, I've got two slides to mention very quickly the SIM4RDM project. Is that okay? I'll do it very quickly in 15 seconds. So JISC is involved in the SIM4RDM project, which is as part of the ERINET program, and is to develop support infrastructure models for research data management. By that, we mean taking some of the outputs of the program, the approach used in designing the Managing Research Data program, comparing that with other interventions used by European funders internationally, and developing metrics and evaluation frameworks for assessing the impact and the effectiveness of such interventions. There's a list of participants there. There's the model which we use, which maps onto the model which I showed at the beginning of the presentation. We look at the motivation, the drivers upon researchers, the need for recognition, and look at the way in which researchers in institutions and across institutions can be supported. The lead on that project is my colleague Matthew Dovey, and if anyone is interested in finding out more about the SIM4RDM project, there are his contact details. Thank you.